The discovery of having a brain tumor can be frightening.
When anyone finds out they have a brain tumor, it is super scary. And so we have to take care of these people. I don't want them to be worrying about, you know, what is going to happen to me if I have this brain tumor. And so what will happen is they will rapidly see us in a multidisciplinary way. I would say within 2 days.
That's what Dr. Albert Kim says the new Brain Tumor Center can provide. Washington University School of Medicine in St. Louis and Barnes Jewish Hospital established new this year the Brain Tumor Center, which is based at Siteman Cancer Center. The Brain Tumor Center is combining efforts in the lab with efforts in the clinic. Transformative research is priority.
The real idea is to make a clinical pipeline, right? So from the very basic discoveries in a Petri dish or in a lab bench, and to really bring that to patients through clinical trials. That's what we're hoping to do with this research center.
It's amazing.
To bring something literally from the bench to the bedside of a patient.
Kim says the center has more than 100 scientists and clinicians in different areas of the medical campus dedicated to benign and malignant tumors. The Brain Tumor Center will be part of the 11-story neuroscience research building now under construction on the Washington University Medical Campus at Duncan and Newstead Avenues. This is the largest project in the School of Medicine history. The Brain Tumor Center will have 10 core research groups. This will be the basic science arm of brain tumor research. The Brain Tumor Center will bring the groups together on one floor of the new building, taking up half of a full floor. Kim says having the investigators together in the neuroscience research building, among other neuroscience research groups, creates synergy.
Different people together, they all have their individual research programs and collaborators. But now you have them interacting in the same space. I would imagine literally passing each other. That would lead to discussions and new ideas about therapies.
Different groups within neuroscience and in other areas of medicine already collaborate. In this example, Dr. Michael Diamond is a leading researcher of Zika virus, the virus transmitted by mosquitoes. The professor of medicine, molecular microbiology, pathology, and immunology worked closely with neurologist and neuro-oncologist Dr. Milan Chaita. They discovered Zika virus helps destroy deadly brain cancer in mice. This unlocks a potential Zika virus-based therapy to treat the aggressive and deadly brain tumor, glioblastoma.
None of this would be possible if we all were just staying in our lanes and weren't talking and cross-fertilizing ideas. So really, I think it's science at its best when you have people who are highly collaborative and coming at problems from all different directions.
I think just by having Dr. Chaita in this brain tumor space, that will bring new ideas, for instance, about Zika or other things he studies, for instance, cancer stem cells. And then he'll be next to, for instance, Dr. Hong Chen, who is part of radiation oncology, who uses really advanced technology like focused ultrasound to not only kill tumors, but to open up the blood-brain barrier. And so you have these different people together. They all have their individual research programs and collaborators, but now you have them interacting in the same space. I would imagine, for instance, people in my lab or Dr. Chaita's lab would be just literally passing each other, you know, and that would lead to discussions and new ideas about therapies.
Kim says this approach to research would provide the most up-to-date, precise, and effective treatments.
Encouraging new treatments through clinical trials. And I would say that's some of the main ways in which the Brain Tumor Center will interface with Siteman. Within that patient-centric clinical care program, we have a number of sub-programs. On the adult side, we have primary malignancy, and that would include people, for instance, with glioblastomas and other types of gliomas. And then we have a benign program, because it turns out, I would say something on the order of half of brain tumors are actually not cancer. They're benign, like meningiomas and adenomas in the pituitary gland. And then we also have a brain metastasis program, because it turns out that many cancers arise, you know, they come into the brain from other parts of the body, right? For instance, like a lung cancer or breast cancer. And then on the pediatric side, there's a pediatric neuro-oncology clinical program as well. And they have very similar sub-programs.
The Brain Tumor Center's comprehensive approach to research is delivering groundbreaking results.
The immunotherapy program, and that's led by Gavin Dunn. And one of the exciting trials we have through that program is what we call the neoantigen vaccine trial. And that's basically making a tumor vaccine for patients with glioblastoma. And we also have an epigenetics and genomics program. And that's where we're really getting deeper. Precision medicine on steroids is maybe a good way to put it. And then we have a device technology program. And I know perhaps this is less well known to people, but we're sort of really thought leaders in a few different technologies, including laser. So now we're putting lasers into people's brains and killing tumors inside out.
Creating synergy among clinicians is also the mission.
I essentially see the person. I walk into the common area where we're looking at all the records, putting in notes. And there's my buddy, medical oncologist and a radiation oncologist. And I can ask them right away. That person will also be seeing the patient right after me. And in some cases at the same time. And so we really have this packaged multidisciplinary approach. And it's better for the patient because they can get answers right away, a final recommendation right away. And, you know, it makes it also much more streamlined for us as clinicians. And so everybody wins.